In section 4, we're going to talk about multimedia data analysis focused around images and image processing. We're going to start out by talking about the major ImageIO package within Java, how to analyze just your basic images, JPEGs and PNGs, and then we're going to move forward into more advanced image analysis, talking about how to do facial detection, facial recognition, and then various types of pattern recognition in images. We're going to talk right now about image processing in Java. And the way that we're going to cover this is we're going to focus on the image formats, the number of different image formats that we have to deal with. Then we're going to talk about Java ImageIO that was introduced way back in Java AWT. And we're going to cover a series of basic ImageIO operations. Now, there are quite a few different image formats from just about everywhere. There's JPEGs, there's GIFs, there's PNGs, there's BMPs, and ultimately there are a lot of different file formats, and we don't want to have to become experts at each individual file format in order to deal with it. So the role of ImageIO, this was introduced quite a while back in that all of those image formats, the PNGs, your JPEGs, they're ultimately just a two-dimensional array of pixels based on XY coordinates. So rather than forcing every individual developer to understand every file format and figure out how to do things like get the color at a certain set of pixels or draw a line across it or figure out how to subset that image, ImageIO was introduced as a way of abstracting that to deal with the actual output of the image rather than the file format itself. And there's always a question of, well, what formats can I actually process within ImageIO? What is it that I can deal with? There's quite a few of them. JPEGs, PNGs, WebPMs, and different formats being introduced pretty much all the time. So there's a series of methods in ImageIO that you can use to help you get this information, such as ImageIO get reader format names, get writer format names, the differences, one you can read, the other you can write. And there are other methods with similar naming designations for format names and MIME types. And the question is it JPEG with an E, which is the official file format name, or is it just JPG, which almost everybody uses? The answer, if you look at it, it actually has both, but I tend to use JPG just because that's the most common one that you see everywhere. Or when you go to download it, it's typically the file extension. Also, can we add file formats? Can we add more formats to ImageIO? And the answer is yes. If you have a new file format, or if you want to go download a ImageIO plugin for adding a new format, you're absolutely welcome to. I had to do this on a project of my own quite a while ago when I wanted to be able to read information and pictures off of an onboard Raspberry Pi camera. It returns pictures in a format called PPM, which is not a part of the base Java ImageIO. So I actually located an image format recognition by a company called MMS Computing from a long time ago and repackaged that along with a customized webcam driver for Raspberry Pis that you're welcome to download if you like. And now what we're going to do is we're going to go into a demo, opening a class file called ImageIO demo. Now I'm going to switch back over to my IDE right here where I have ImageIO demo open. And the first thing that I'm going to do here is just to print out a list of all the image formats that can be processed because I want to know what it is that my system can handle. So I'm going to stream through our ImageIO.getReaderFormatNames, which is an array. I'm going to indent that a little bit and just print them out to the console. And then what I'm going to do, I have a couple different methods. I'm going to read an image in called packedpub_mapped.jpg, which is this screenshot that I took a little bit ago of the core Pact Publishing website that showcases the mapped subscription. And then I'm going to use that image and I'm going to convert it from a JPEG to a PNG and write some text to it. Then I'm going to shrink it. And then I'm going to take a minor subset of that image. So to walk through each in terms of the conversion, this is your basic Java NIO. So I'm going to put it into a file called converted.png, convert it right here, actually go back up, ImageIO.read, the very first thing that I have to do is to read it. The difference of using ImageIO.read is it passes it through those service provider interfaces, so you get an actual buffered image that you can work with, read its graphics, and interact with. So now in my conversion method, I set up my output stream. And what I want to do, because I want to convert it, actually, I'm going to draw some text on it first before I do that, just to demonstrate some of the things that we can do. Image in.create graphics, that gets me my graphics 2D. I'm going to do a little nice transform, rotate it a little bit, use a large font, and I'm going to write the word converted over top of it. And then I'm going to output that as PNG, whereas you'll notice my original one is just called JPEG. So if I execute this, and I look at my file called converted, you see I have my word converted right here across the upper left at the index that we have, and it looks essentially the same. So all we did was we wrote the word converted on it, and we flipped its file format from JPEG to PNG. Now, in terms of shrink, we often want to generate thumbnails from images that we have. So what we want to be able to do is to shrink an image, have it look exactly the same, but be a little bit smaller. So it's the same thing. We have our buffered image that comes in. We set up our output stream for wherever we want to write it. And the new width, we just use the original one, get its width, divide it by whatever we want. I'm going to make it about a fourth of the size. And we get a scaled instance. Now, the last element in a scaled instance is an integer set that you are bit set for how you want to interact with it. The most common one that I use is called scale smooth so that I get a nicely translated image. And then for shrunk image, I set my image to the new width and new height. And you'll notice I'm creating a new buffered image. And because I'm passing type int ARGB, that indicates that I want all of my RGB color arrays in terms of having it be a colored image, not a black and white image. Shrunk image.create graphics. So right here, I have to set up a new set of graphics over top of this new image because we don't want to interact with the old image anymore. New graphics, simply draw that to the image of the scaled one that we had created earlier based on the same size, dispose of my graphics, and it's this shrunk image that I want to write out. So if I come up here and I look at my shrunk image, you'll see it's the same image. It looks the same. If we look at the top left, it actually has that yellow bar there that says the word converted from the one before. So that's a fourth of the size. And the reason it still has that word converted up there in the top left is that inside here of convert, I worked on the image in itself, so I manipulated and edited the original image. Now, if I come down to some sub-image, sometimes what you want to be able to do is to get a certain part of an image out based on the pixel size. So what I do, it's the same thing as before, output path, output stream. This time I'm going to save myself a little bit of time, so I'm going to add this format up here for JPEG. That's what I'm going to pass into my ImageIO writer because that's the name of the writer spy. ImageIO writers.get format name. This is so that I can create a writer. And sometimes when you shrink things or deal with them, you want to change the compression quality. So by doing this and converting it to a JPEG, I can say that I want it compressed. I want the focus on the file size rather than the quality. And in this case, I've picked out the word mapped here. So the start X is about 170. The start Y is about 210. And the word mapped is about 200 pixels wide by 100 pixels long. So this is the rectangle that I want to grab over here. And if I execute this original.get subimage, start X, start Y, width, height, and this is how I get only a subset. And you'll notice it returns a buffered image. So this is a copy of what that original element was. So I'm ultimately going to write that out to my output stream here, which is called subimage.format, so subimage.jpg. And if I flip over after execution to this, you'll notice I get the word mapped here, which comes out of the word right there. So I was able to grab only a subregion of this using ImageIO. So as a result of walking through this application, we have an example of three things that you can do using ImageIO: converting it from one file format to another, shrinking it to generate thumbnails, and subimage grabbing only a smaller subset of a picture. And what are some other cool things that you can do with ImageIO? Well, some of the basic things that people tend to do is to recolor images, take a colored image and convert it to black and white. There's the role of making thumbnails on the fly, or you can also use that text rotation to create custom captures if you want. And if you want to follow up a little bit more about the role of ImageIO, it's documented in the overall Java SE tutorials in terms of the 2D framework. Other ImageIO points of interest is by default, it caches files when you go to write them to any output stream. It will write them to a file and create them back. And this will actually fail if you write it on a, or if you use it on a read-only system, such as Raspberry Pi, and it may cause some excessive writes on a flash drive. On a regular system, desktop, laptop, server, you won't notice any difference, but on a Raspberry Pi, because they deal specifically with fail-heavy flash cards, it may cause a problem. But the way that you can deal with this is there's a method in there called imageio.setUseCache, and if you pass false into there, it won't write those cached files anymore. Another nice library that you might want to use is something called Sarxos Webcam that you can use to integrate video capture and grab pictures out of webcams if you like.